अडवाणी जी हमारे प्रेरणा स्त्रोत्र रहे, हमारे श्रेष्ठ नेता रहे, कल भी थे, आज भी और कल भी रहेंगे। अब वो ऐसा है कि नेचुरल कोर्स में कुछ उम्र के बाद तो बदलाव होते ही रहता है, और इसलिए मुझे लगता है अडवाणी जी से बातचीत होकर पार्टी के अध्यक्ष जी ने उचित निर्णय किया है।
Shrimati Tejaswini Anant Kumar ma'am spoke, she's like a mother figure to me. She has very clearly stated that all of us are together, the party is about everything else.
उन्होंने योजना बना करके ये काम किया है, यानी जो पार्टी है उसमें यदि मुख्यधारा में ये लोग रहते तो ये पार्टी इस तरह से खराब होने का काम नहीं होता।
गुड इवनिंग, नमस्कार, आदाब। एज दे से लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन इज नो बार इन लव एंड वॉर। नाउ वी ऑल नो दैट द गेम ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स इज एन एक्सट्रीमली ब्रूटल गेम वेर इमोशंस डोंट मैटर। द ओनली थिंग दैट मैटर्स इज, एज पॉलिटिशियंस ऑलवेज टॉक अबाउट, विनेबिलिटी। नाउ अमित शाह एंड नरेंद्र मोदी हैव बीन एट ग्रेट पेंस ओवर द लास्ट वन वीक टू टेल अस दैट द ओनली थिंग दैट मैटर्स ऑन द रोड टू 2019 इज that they have to choose those candidates who have the best possible potential of retaining their seats. It appears on that specific front, L.K. Advani and Murali Manohar Joshi, both former presidents of the BJP, both people who could be credited perhaps for playing a stellar role in the BJP's journey from two seats over 200 seats and now at 282 seats, both of them are not a part of the BJP scheme of things now. Is it because of age factor? Is it that a 91-year-old L.K. Advani, who certainly is responsible for creating a certain ideological mooring of the BJP, has L.K. Advani simply outlived his shelf life? He may not be able to contest. Is he also not good enough today to campaign? Should L.K. Advani not have a voice within the affairs of the Bharatiya Janata Party? After all, not many of us have forgotten Advani's famous rebellion against Narendra Modi as Prime Ministerial candidate, Murali Manohar Joshi and L.K. Advani coming together post the Bihar assembly election debacle and putting out a joint statement asking for some self-introspection has also not been forgotten. So what are we talking about? Are we talking about age, or are we talking about settling of personal scores tonight? What is of greater interest to me, though, is what's happened in Karnataka, a seat which has been held by the Bharatiya Janata Party now, by the late Anant Kumar, former union minister, today a 28-year-old youngster who's not from the family of Anant Kumar, gets that ticket, gets that seat, despite the claim which was being made by Anant Kumar's own wife. Tejaswi Surya, all of 28, today is the BJP candidate from Bangalore South. On the other hand, you have Murali Manohar Joshi and L.K. Advani, who are clearly not happy with the way the rub has turned. And it gives a sense that somewhere along the line, Murali Manohar Joshi, L.K. Advani are feeling done in, and Tejaswi Surya believes that this is the beginning of a new life for him. Is this new life for him based on merit? Is this new life for Tejaswi Surya based on winnability? And is this old life of L.K. Advani and Murali Manohar Joshi being denied any opportunity? Maybe because they're not good enough to win their seats. Let's take you behind the story. And let's show you how, as far as this age tracker is concerned, on our election data wall, let's explain to you how age, when it matters to some political parties, can be a great virtue, and when it doesn't matter to some political parties, it can be a huge hassle. H.C. Devegowda, former Prime Minister, 85 years old, he's fighting from the Tumkuru seat in Karnataka, but L.K. Advani, at the age of 91, has been asked to make way for the present BJP President, Amit Shah, in Gandhinagar. Farooq Abdullah, father of Omar Abdullah, 81, contesting. Murali Manohar Joshi, 85, in the words of Murali Manohar Joshi himself, he's been told that he cannot the seat, he cannot contest on the seat of Kanpur. Ajit Singh, boss of the Rashtriya Lok Dal, known political mover, has done business with all political parties, from the BJP to the Congress to the Samajwadi Party to the Bahujan Samaj Party, 80 years old, contesting, and looks at a certain future for himself. Shanta Kumar comes from Himachal Pradesh. He has been also asked to make way, no such space for him. Mulayam Singh Yadav, the great Mulayam Singh Yadav, the great Netaji, once a wrestler, continues to wrestle, sometimes with his own son as well, at the age of 79, is still fighting from Mainpuri in Uttar Pradesh. Karya Munda in Kunti has been asked to make way. The list goes on and on. Shankar Singh Waghela, contesting, may decide to contest from Gandhinagar in Gujarat. Now one doesn't know because Amit Shah is contesting from that area. Mallikarjun Kharge, again, he is contesting from Gulbarga constituency in Karnataka. The point is that there is not much of a difference between, say, an 81-year-old person and an 85-year-old person. If an 81-year-old person is fighting fit, and if an 85-year-old person also feels that he is fighting fit, if there are no physical ailments, then on what grounds is a particular position being taken that just because you're 85, you cannot be fighting an election? Where do I stand on this question? Let's take a straightforward position. I believe politics and politicians, it's a tough life. There is no doubt about that. Politics and politicians are supposed to mature with age. In India, this maturity that we often talk about, that we often hope for, this sagacity that's expected out of the class of netas, this maturity and sagacity often gets overtaken by the sheer lust to hold on to power. Now, we can certainly have a debate, and we will have a debate, on whether respect was being shortchanged by the BJP while dealing with its elders. But there is no denying that young blood has to come forward. And that young blood is not going to come forward unless the old guard makes way. Is the old guard willing to make way, or does the old guard necessarily have to be pushed aside? That's where I stand. Let's raise a big blunt question and see whether the panelists agree or disagree with me. In elections, in politics, can there ever be a retirement age? Should we look for retirement age? If CEOs of a company, if CFOs of a company, if corporate sector can have a retirement age, then why not? Why not the political class? Full panel on all sides joining us here with us in our studios. A very special panel. Dilip Cherian, founder of Perfect Relations, keeps a close eye on all things corporate as well as political. Tuin Sinha, representing the Bharatiya Janata Party. Pratap Mittal, founder of Neta App, and someone who's going to be with us all through this election season. Rashid Kidwai, another one of our fellow election travelers, is here, and Pawan Khera, representing the Congress Party. Warm welcome to all of you. Look forward to an enlightened debate on whether I myself should be looking at a retirement age from my profession when it comes to a certain age. So, Tuin Sinha, let me first kick off with you. What's the story behind Murali Manohar Joshi? Why does Dr. Joshi make this statement public that I have been told by Ram Lal that I should not be contesting the Kanpur Lok Sabha seat?
Well, Bhupendra, age is an important referencing tool in deciding the role and responsibility of an individual. Be it politics, be it family, be it sports, or be it, business. So, yes, in India, we've had instances where people have fought elections even at 91 in the past, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
But then this is a slightly different India where 50% of the population is below the age of 35. So while age alone cannot be a factor, when you combine it with other factors like, individual's involvement, participation, and many other factors depend upon age. With all due respect to Mr. Advaniji, who I consider my idol, in the last 5 years, despite a 92% attendance in Parliament, did not speak more than 400 words. This is not the Advaniji we knew. So, I think after being in Parliament for 50 years, one needs to make way for the younger generation, which is what is happening.
And what about Dr. Joshi?
Well, again, the circumstances are similar.
The circumstances are not similar at all, because I can tell you that while I completely agree with you, as far as L.K. Advani is concerned, I think if you've crossed 90, and L.K. Advani's contribution to the growth of the BJP, contentious or otherwise, is there, is for everyone to accept. But for Murali Manohar Joshi, why does he write this open letter? Is he not expressing his vote of no confidence with the manner in which things have been handled in the BJP?
I would not be privy to what exactly happened between Ram Lal ji and Murali Manohar Joshi ji. But what I can tell you is that 10 years back, You know, we had a whole campaign around 2009 elections led by an 81-year-old prime ministerial aspirant.
You think that was a mistake?
No, that was not a mistake. What I'm trying to say is that for us, age is not the only factor. That gets combined with many other factors, the most important and the end result of which is winnability.
Let me take you on the question of winnability. And maybe our producers can put up this graphic, this election trajectory of Murali Manohar Joshi versus the person who's been chosen by the BJP today to replace Murali Manohar Joshi from Kanpur. Dr. Joshi happens to be a member of parliament between 1977 to 1985. Between 1996 to 2004, uninterrupted stint in Indian parliament from Murali Manohar Joshi as a member of parliament from Allahabad. In 2009, he moves to Varanasi. In 2014, he becomes an MP from Kanpur. Look at Satyadev Pachauri. Satyadev Pachauri, 2004, loses from Kanpur. 2009, party does not consider him good enough to be given a ticket. 1991, he won from Aryanagar constituency in UP. 2012, well, elected from Govindnagar. And 2017, again elected from Govindnagar. So he wins his assembly seat, but doesn't manage to hold on to a Lok Sabha seat. Why isn't Satyadev Pachauri a replacement for Murali Manohar Joshi?
What happened in the past, unfortunately, has
not. No, you told me winnability. I've given you the story of winnability.
So people evolve with time. You know, maybe 10 years ago he did not have the resources. Today he has learned the game the hard way. Today he has learned to be
a winnable candidate.
No, I mean, with age you obviously lose that competitive edge.
Really?
There are many other factors.
Dilip?
I think we are harping too much on that single factor of age.
Dilip, I have great regard for you. And you know, I mean, I think on this panel, while I have no hair, but you certainly have the mass amount of white hair. Because you have white hair, therefore you're losing your Midas touch. Is that what I understand from Tuhin?
I think that there is possibly one thing we are forgetting. The role of the new voter. And the BJP is probably punting very heavily on the first time voter. A large cohort of people have entered this market, and don't forget that in the last elections, new voters voted at a percentage which was higher than the rest of the average voters. So I have a feeling that the age thing, which has come out like a guillotine, is probably because there is some game plan which has to do with attracting first-time voters. That's probably one of the things that they're playing with.
Pavanji, would you agree with that, Pavanji, that the best way to attract this first-time voter, as Tuhin says, is to go in for younger people? So let's keep whoever is, you know, I mean, I don't know what you're planning to do, say, for instance, with Hansraj Bhardwaj. And I don't know the entire galaxy of the old leaders that the country's oldest political party has. But is that something that works for the Congress party as well? Best way to get rid of young voters is to put in young candidates?
I absolutely respect, not just because of his grey hair, because of his wisdom, Dilip Charian. Having said that, I'd like to counter him. 2014 election, there was our leader, who is definitely younger than Narendra Modi, but the first time voters opted for Narendra Modi for whatever reasons. So I don't buy this argument that FTVs will vote only for the young. Sheila Dixit, she's 80. The Congress party, in its wisdom, and rightly so, realized that she can still attract people, voters of Delhi. And she was brought back in Delhi. Sukhram today joined Congress. So I think whether it's your profession or Dilip Charian's profession or my profession, these are three professions where if you're of sound mind and health, there is no retirement age. There is a minimum age prescribed, 25, when you can contest the election. But there is no maximum age prescribed. Winnability, my friend Tuhin Sinha was talking about winnability. Smriti Irani has never won an election, but she has been fielded. Shahnawaz Hussain has won elections in the past, lost the last election by 9,000 votes, was denied a ticket. So I don't know what factors are we talking about, though it's an internal matter of their party. Murali Manohar Joshi, one understands, he openly, as head of the Parliamentary Committee on Defence, criticised the government, this government, for its defence preparedness. So maybe there is some revenge here, there is some vindictiveness. My friend Tuhin says that Advaniji barely spoke in the parliament. I'm sorry, that's not Advaniji's choice. That's the parliamentary affairs minister. That's the chief whip of your party who decides who will speak and who will not speak. So let's understand what's the legislative procedure here. Don't blame him for not speaking. Blame yourself for not giving him any opportunities. Mark Darshak Mandal. How many times did the Mark Darshak Mandal have a meeting? Show me one. Give me one example of the Mark Darshak Mandal meeting.
But Pavanji, are you then arguing that age should not be a criterion? Let us not look for any retirement age in politics. As long as you can deliver, as long as you can deliver, as long as you can deliver, you should work.
Or in journalism.
Yeah?
Why not? Yeah? I would like to see Bhupen Chaubey 30 years later also.
No, I would like to retire at the, as soon
Bhupen,
as
I would like to see you.
I would much as you'd like
that's
to see me,
choice,
I'd like to retire, but that's
as a viewer.
Yeah, but I'm just saying.
As a viewer, I would like to see you, maybe your own channel,
but
if you're of sound mind, why should you retire?
But Rashid,
unless it's your choice.
That's an interesting argument, Rashid, which is being made by Pawan Khera. Why should you make age a criterion? If you have a medical ailment, like I'm saying, I think there is a distinction, say, between an L.K. Advani and a Murli Manohar Joshi. At the age of 91, maybe Mr. Advani is not in the pink of his health, but I know Murli Manohar Joshi personally. I mean, he seems to be perfectly capable of getting on with his business. Why should Murli Manohar Joshi then be denied of an opportunity to contest? Rashid?
Yes, absolutely. Bhupen, this is a matter of this is a doctrine of necessity that works. Necessity that is suitable to the leader. I mean, you look at Congress today. Congress can, of course, be very sympathetic towards L.K. Advani and Murli Manohar Joshi. But look at its own track record when Rajiv Gandhi was at one over 400 seats. Look at the way he treated a leader like Kamalapati Tripathi. And there is a whole list of Congress people who were not treated. It's just not a matter about P.V. Narasimha Rao or Sitaram Kesari. So it is politics. I mean, age, to my mind, is not a big consideration, as my friend Mr. Dilip Charyan is making out to be. It is fashionable to talk about age factor. You look at every time there's been big change in Indian politics, it's not normally led by a youngster, whether it was Mahatma Gandhi or Anna Saab Hazare or V.P. Singh or Jayaprakash Narayan. All this time, the big movements were led by people who are, they were senior citizens. So this is not a thing.
Political. So am I to understand that actually while we try and make a distinction on the basis of age, what is actually being done by Tuin Sinha's party or what may have been done by Pawan Khera's party in the past, Rashid, is that we have used age basically to get rid of people that we don't like.
Precisely.
When leaders don't like a certain individual, they don't get on with that individual. They decide, fine, iska time ho gaya, let me apply this principle, let me get rid of him. Is that what you're saying, Rishi?
This is exactly that happens. And many a times, you see, I have a personal knowledge that Sonia Gandhi wanted to retire at the age of 70. She wanted to set an example, but circumstances forced her to come out of retirement. So it is not just a matter of choice. There are all kind of pulls and pressure and dynamics work.
So Pawan Khera is clear there. That as long as you can contest, if you are physically fit, then why not? Then why should you not continue to be in the game of politics? And as he rightly argues, well, Sheila Dikshit at the age of 80 is still the chief of the Delhi Pradesh Congress Committee. But Tuin, is that what's happening then? Whether it is Shanta Kumar, whether it is Murli Manohar Joshi, and I don't know who else should be dealt with in the BJP's long list, are you basically getting rid of people? Because you feel that this lot does not fit in well with your existing decision-making mechanism.
You need to draw a distinction between the BJP and the Congress. I heard Kidwai Saab also saying both parties do the same thing. There's a huge difference. I can tell you the BJP respects its seniors. We will never do what the Congress did to Sitaram Kesari, locked him in a room on the day that the resolution was passed to remove him. We will never do what they did to P.V. Narasimha Rao, where his dead body was not allowed inside the Congress headquarters. We know how to respect our seniors. But like I said, age is one of the factors. The overall, three or four factors lead to the winnability quotient. And over here, age just adds up to it. The day we find our Robert Mugabe, we will have a 90-year-old prime minister or president.
So you're saying that age as such, you're also in agreement then with what Pawan Khera is saying? That age cannot be the only determining factor?
It's one of the factors I started by saying.
Yeah, but then I'm not understanding what has happened with Murli Manohar Joshi. I mean, neither on the question of winnability nor on the question of age, on both fronts, your argument is flawed. Then why have you denied Murli Manohar Joshi an opportunity?
I think there is a committee that that looks into these things and takes the decision. I'm sure they took a considered decision. Why would you go by the assumption that he has been harmed?
Am I going by the assumption? Let me bring in Pratham Mittal then, who's the co-founder of Neta app platform. Neta, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, is a fascinating platform which has been developed by young Pratham Mittal, who happens to be perhaps the youngest member on the panel. Let's find out from your app, Pratham.
Sure.
Let me take on what Tuin is saying. That there is a committee. The committee would have concluded that Murli Manohar Joshi is not the best person to be contesting from Kanpur. Is that the trend that you pick up in your app?
So, you know, after this announcement was made in the morning, we did a survey. And we had over 5 lakh people participate in the survey.
Okay.
Right? And specifically, we did the survey in Kanpur as well, in addition.
And how many people were there in Kanpur?
In Kanpur, there were around 22,000 people.
22,000. Okay.
I think that's a fair
that's
size.
A reasonably
that's
reasonable
a reasonable size, right? And so the question was, should Mr. Murali Manohar Joshi been offered a ticket? Right? And almost 45% people actually agree to that. They believe that he should have been offered a ticket.
45%?
45%. 55% say, no, he did not deserve one.
Okay.
If you look at Kanpur specifically, 54 people agreed that he deserves a ticket.
54%?
54%. So, to me, that is not sort of...
Now, how does one explain this then to him? Why should I not argue what is being suggested?
Ageism is a convenient cudgel. That's what
I'm saying.
At the appropriate turn, then to be used on those who are identified.
Let's conclude that.
Instead of jumping the gun, let us wait till the election results.
No, no. What election results?
Election
results is a secondary question. I'm not suggesting that Satyadev Pachauri may lose the election. He may well go on to win the election. But is Murali Manohar Joshi, is he right if he was feeling done in today? At the age of 85, he still has the ability to contest an election.
See, I wouldn't know what exactly happened between Ramlalji and him, but what I can tell you is that we respect our seniors.
You respect your seniors. Bhagwan Kera, he respects his seniors, but he says you don't respect your seniors. Or are both of you equally guilty when it comes to dealing with people? You use age as a convenient tool to deal with people.
No, we don't. As I said, no, we don't. The fact that the entire country saw the shabby treatment meted out on Mr. Advani, whether it was on the stage in Tripura or whether it was here in Delhi, often you have seen in the last 5 years, Advani ji has been really treated very shabbily. At the end of the day, Bhupen, there is a political capital every leader builds over the last 20, 30 years or 2, 3, 4 decades of public life. Now, you cannot summarily dismiss the fact that they do have a political capital. We may disagree with Mr. Advani, we can never agree with their ideology. Having said that, we are only talking about public life right now and the merits of this particular decision. Why should the... Again, it's a personal matter, their own private matter. But since you are having a debate, there is a particular ecosystem being brought in by Mr. Modi and Mr. Shah. What is that ecosystem? It is a cult ecosystem. You will not hear a ghar ghar Bhajapa, you will say ghar ghar Modi. So that hero worship, that, you know, individual centric politics. Now that cult worship within the BJP is replacing all existing systems of the BJP. Some of them may have been good in the past, some of them may not have been so good, but what they are replacing it with is something horrifying. So an entire party cannot really depend on... People often accuse the Congress party of not being democratic enough. I'll give you one recent example of Delhi, the alliance issue of in Delhi. And I'm talking very frankly. The central leadership left it to the state leadership. Aap decide kari, whatever you say. The state leadership, all the three working presidents and the president of the PCC, decided that they were against the alliance. So there is a tremendous amount of democracy in our party. We absolutely encourage bottom-up approach, aap jo batayenge wo zyada jayaz hoga. Look at the ticket distribution mechanism adopted by the Congress party in this election. It's amazing. It's absolutely decentralized. It does not have the high command culture at all. There is no
so basically the BJP today has become what the Congress used to be
currently going on. It's becoming
Rashid,
what the Congress was accused of.
No,
I wouldn't say Congress used
Rashid,
to that.
Has the BJP
what the Congress
become,
was accused of.
Is Pawan Kera basically saying that the BJP today has become what, to quote Pawanji himself, what the Congress used to be? The Gandhi Parivar would decide today.
No,
Modi Parivar will decide.
Accused of.
It is.
No. You are misquoting me.
Let's misquoting me.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just saying what the Congress. Okay, Congress Party was accused of. Let's accept that.
See, it always happens accused when you have a powerful leader. When you know people are voting for Narendra Modi rather than an individual BJP candidate, this is bound to happen. I mean, Mr. Kera may remember that first election, the Congress slogan was a vote for Nehru is a vote for Congress. So Nehru was more important than the entire Congress party because he was a towering leader. Same thing used to happen in Indira Gandhi time, Rajiv Gandhi time. Today, you see, the Congress can take a stand, but let me tell you, the experience has its own, you know, so
to say charm and relevance. You look at success of Kamal Nath, you look at success of Amrinder Singh, you look at even success of Ashok Gehlot. They all, I mean, Amrinder and Kamal Nath are over 70. Gehlot is just nearing 70. So there is, experiences at premium. It depends how a political leadership, uses the kind of, pool of talent that it has. But success defines everything. If, as you are rightly saying, if Mr. Pachauri wins, then, it will, in Bangalore, that the young boy who's contesting
wins,
that will make Mr. Amit Shah and Narendra Modi a success.
Yes, I agree. I mean, success is, many fathers and failures is done.
Absolutely.
But I'm trying to look at what's happening within the BJP's scheme of things. Dilip, look at the age factor and look at the names of the leaders that we're talking about. Bhuvan Chand Khanduri, former union minister, 84 years old. Today, he's got a son on a Congress ticket. Bhagat Singh Koshyari, 76 years, opted out of polls. Sushma Swaraj, 67, has not had the best of health over the last few years, opts out. Uma Bharti, 59, opts out. The one common strand that I see, and the age is from 59 to 84, is that these are all individuals who may not have necessarily enjoyed the best of relationship with the present-day BJP high command. Is that the reason why these people are opting out?
There's another way of putting it. These are people who are individuals in their own right and who are, in a sense, not spokespersons for their parties, but outspoken people. And perhaps the party is trying to create a more unified structure, for want of a better word. You might say Pawan Khera, I think, use the word cult. The fact is that you are hearing only one voice. And that is the direction that seems to be finding favor in the way the committees are also.
But surely, Dilip, you'd agree that Murali Manohar Joshi is no match to Narendra Modi today.
Murali Manohar Joshi is an independent voice, as you just saw from his actions in the defense committee. So the fact is that these are people who have not only enormous personal standing, but they also have, in some senses, a popular support which allows them to voice things which are always inconvenient for any powerful leader. And this is true whichever party it is in.
So therefore, Tohin, all these leaders that we're looking at, from Mr. Koshyari to Mr. Khanduri to Sushma Swaraj to Uma Bharti, they don't get on with your leadership, and therefore a situation arises. Now I'm given to believe that Sushma Swaraj, the entire Vidisha unit, the Madhya Pradesh unit of the BJP, is asking Sushma Swaraj to reconsider a decision of opting out, but she's clear, no, I will not contest. Uma Bharti says, I'm not going to contest, I will go on a Ganga Yatra and then I'll prepare a 15-year long trajectory. Basically, are we witnessing the unfolding of an era within the BJP, which is being spoken about by Pawan Khera and Dilip Cherian here, that it's the emergence of a cult? Those who are not on the right side of the cult will fall by the wayside. Is that what's happening?
First of all, the situations are very different in the case of each of these leaders.
How?
In Sushma ji's case, we genuinely know she's not in great health.
Yes.
She doesn't want a constituency, which is far away from Delhi, where she would anyway have to travel, apart from a flight journey, a few other hours to reach there. So she would be there, most probably there in the Rajya Sabha. In Uma Bharti ji's case, again, she is not keeping in great health. So the situation is different.
By the way, let me point out, Uma Bharti wants to go on an year-long Ganga Yatra. If she's going on an year-long Ganga Yatra, surely her health will be good enough.
Thanks to inland waterways, that's become a lot smoother than what it used to be during the Congress days. But anyway, I think the situation is different in each of the cases, like Dilip himself said. And in some cases, if the leaders have held their own position, that does not mean they are at loggerheads with the central leadership.
How? But I'm looking example after the example that I'm giving you today.
If you really want to give an example.
What had happened between Sushma Swaraj and the Prime Minister in 2014. We all know how Sushma Swaraj wanted to push up the stock of Shivraj Singh Chauhan in 2014. We all know Uma Bharti, who was a former chief minister, she did not want to be in UP. She wanted to be in Madhya Pradesh. But a situation was created. So today, you say that Sushma Swaraj is not well, but I see Sushma Swaraj is campaigning. You say Uma Bharti is not well, but I see Uma Bharti is busy campaigning around the entire Ganga Yatra.
You have been a political journalist for 20 years.
Which is why I'm trying to understand what's
going politics,
on.
Politics can't be about absolute benevolence. You know that.
So you're admitting it.
I'm saying
at the end of the day, we need positive results.
Punishing.
We need a cohesive leadership.
You are punishing people who are not considerate.
That's your. That's what you are assuming.
You just use the word benevolent. What else do I make out of this?
What I'm saying is that, you know, benevolence does not mean that the opposite of benevolence does not mean that you are absolutely ruthless. What I'm trying to say is that there are a lot of factors which go on to make a winning combination, a certain cohesiveness, a certain performance which this government has managed to deliver.
Should I use the word ruthless for the present day BJP dispensation, Dilip?
There's benevolence, there's banality, and there's brutal. You have to choose one of these three.
So which word should be chosen? Because
Let me tell you what is brutal. Yes. Forget retired leaders. Even a sitting octogenarian prime minister and an external affairs minister have been on record to say that the young Rahul Gandhi's overbearing attitude, S.M. Krishna has been on record to say that, and the overbearing attitude of Rahul Gandhi made him feel humiliated. Have you seen the BJP ever, you know, create a situation like this? He tore an affidavit where a 79-80-year-old prime minister was humiliated. Have you seen the BJP indulge in something like this? That is the difference between the BJP and the Congress, and you need to appreciate that.
But I'm on the question of age. I'm on the question. You take an S.M. Krishna into the BJP. I don't expect S.M. Krishna to say anything else other than abuse the Congress party, which he does. I'm only trying to understand whether all these people, from Murali Manohar Joshi to Mr. Koshyari to Mr. Kanduri, to all these great leaders,
in each cases.
Are they being punished?
No.
They're not being punished.
They're not being punished.
Dashit Kidwai, do you buy this argument being made here?
I think Mr. Sinha is admitting everything without saying it so.
Yeah.
The fact of the matter is that, you know, BJP could have utilized Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi's talent in, you know, giving him a place in some Raj Bhavan. He would have brought dignity to that office, or office of several other things are there. And more thing is that if Dr. Joshi had to be benched, the manner in which, it's a very brazen manner. I mean, I look at Mr. Ramlal's experience in politics and Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi's contribution. Prime Minister Modi should have called him, and you know, both Mr. Advani and Mr. Dr. Joshi should have come forward and announced their own retirement. They should have been given, you know, time. This exercise should have been done 6 months ago. Now, if anybody is not willing to believe it, I mean, you know, this is very clear. I mean, problem is not about retirement plan. Problem is the manner in which it's being executed.
What word, Pawan Khera? Dilip Charan has used three words: benign, brutal.
Or banal.
Which word would you use, Pawan Khera, to describe what's going on right now?
I think brutal and banal, everything. And Dilip has a better vocabulary than I have. Khata na bahi, Modi aur Shah kahe, wahi sahi. That's what the BJP story in one line is now.
That is where...
Whatever word Dilip wants to give it in one word, he's been in a better position to give a word to this.
But, you know, I'm still trying to understand the connect between age and voter connect. So, Pratham, through your Neta app, is there any evidence that you pick up, that is there any correlation? If a leader crosses the age of 80, this argument which was made both by Dilip Charan as well as by Tuhin Sinha, that the millennials, since 50% of India is now first-time voters, is there any empirical evidence to suggest if you cross 75, then let's say a first-time voter will not vote for you? Is there any evidence to suggest that?
So two data points here that I'd like to mention. The first is a survey, another survey that we did today, where we asked whether there should be a retirement age period, right?
And what was the answer?
Data points here that I'd like to mention. The first is a survey, another survey that we did today, where we asked whether there should be a retirement age period, right?
And what was the answer?
The answer was that 86% people agree that
there should
be a retirement age.
And what should that retirement age be?
That's a question for tomorrow.
Because you know, I mean, in a CEO can join a company at 25, work across, say, 10 different companies by the time he's 55, and at the age of 60, he can hang up his boots. But let's also be honest, a politician has to spend time to nurse a constituency. So for all the right pontification here, that politicians must retire, the truth is that by the time you nurse a constituency, you end up spending 15, 20 years.
Absolutely.
Which means that you, by the time, if you contest your first election, say, by around about 30, you are already 50 by the time you've made a constituency Why should you then think in terms of giving up that constituency? So while 86% people say that you should retire, is there any evidence to suggest that out of those people who want this retirement, do they look at age as a criterion when they vote for people?
So let's look at one more data point here, yes. Right? Let's look at what you asked in the beginning, which is there a correlation between age and performance?
Right.
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 So for each politician, we track their approval ratings in their constituency. And what we see is that there's sort of a bell curve, right? When you are at around 45 to 55, that's when your approval ratings are the highest.
Between 45 and 55.
55. That's when your approval ratings are the highest. It's almost 3.71 as compared to 3.35 when you're above 75. Right, so there is a correlation there.
There
right.
is a correlation.
After 45, the approval ratings significantly.
Kamalji, would you accept that? I mean, you know, you worked with Sheila Dixit for so long. At the age of 80, when Sheila Dixit has seen the rise and rise of the Congress Party in Delhi, and then seen a complete shift of the Congress vote to the Aam Aadmi Party, or what use is Sheila Dixit today? Tell me, at the age of 80, then in Delhi.
Come and see the crowds that she is attracting in her political meetings. You will know, you will get the answer. You can get the answer in the enthusiasm shown by our workers. At the end of the day, people, voters respond to the memory of what this person has done when she was in government. Workers respond to the fact that they remember, they know that she brought the Congress to a particular level. And therefore, I don't think age, you gave an example, Ashok Gehlot yourself, Kamal Nath yourself. So these are, age can never be. And Tuhin has very safely created a space for Modi even when he turns 90. He can still try his luck to be the Prime Minister. He said if we have someone like Robert Mugabe, which essentially means Advani ji is not like Robert Mugabe, Murali Manohar Joshi is not like Robert Mugabe, but Modi ji may. Of course, he's losing this election, but maybe he can try his luck again when he turns 90.
No, but, you know, even on the global stage, even if I have to draw a comparison, say, with the world leadership, Mahathir bin Mohamad, Prime Minister of Malaysia, 93, Sabah Ahmad al-Jaber al-Shaba, Prime Minister of Kuwait, 89, Paul Biya, President of Cameroon, 86, Akihito, Emperor of Japan, 85, Salman bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud, King of Saudi Arabia, 83. The world but political leadership.
But look at the leaders who are making a change.
Yes.
Those are the younger leaders. And there you can see the kind of empathy that the Prime Minister of New Zealand Canada's Trudeau. These are people who are today new age models of success.
So,
and politically, they are attracting a huge swing towards themselves, which was never believable before.
So are we then to conclude, that in a country like India, given the literacy levels, given the education levels, given the economic parameters, it's impossible for us to look at people who are 75 plus as agents of change on the political circuit, and therefore we should think it does a retirement age?
I think a retirement age call, which is in a sense by consensus and a bit fuzzy, it need not be exactly 75, but you know, after 75 you should not be then running for a new office, you know what I mean? So I think there is room to consider that, not by law, but I think the party is exactly as,
but by some consensus,
by some kind of consensus, and the parties would find it smarter to do that as long as our voting cohort is still being added on to. Don't forget that this time in this election, 9% of the total eligible voters are going to be first-time voters. 9%, which is a large number.
So I want to know this 9% first-time voters. If a Murali Manohar Joshi was to be a candidate in Kanpur, how would this 9% out of whatever the percentage of first-time voters would be in Kanpur, this first-time voters in Kanpur, would they have detested Murali Manohar Joshi simply because he was 85 years old?
Not really.
Because you gave me that figure of 45% approval ratings of Murali
Manohar Joshi. Right, exactly. So in Kanpur, 54%, actually. And if you look at the younger people in Kanpur, the 54% doesn't change too much. The point is that in general, the public wants there to be a retirement age. But specifically in the case of Mr. Murali Manohar Joshi, they perhaps don't.
So if there is an emotional connect, and that's why I was arguing strike an emotional connect, it requires time. People need to work for 2-3 decades before they can say that this constituency has been nursed as their territory. Look at a Baramati by Sharad Pawar. Look at a Raebareli Amethi. I mean, Rahul Gandhi today can proudly claim Amethi to be his pocket borough because there is a certain Gandhi family connect. In each state of this country, there are areas which have been nursed by politicians. And to nurse that constituency, it requires time. So while we may talk about retirement age, I think it's also important to highlight sometimes it's just the emotional connect. As long as an emotional connect is there, whether you're 55, 65, 75 or 85, why should it matter? Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on this edition of Viewpoint. The consensus is it's not age, but it's merit. If you are in a position in which you can deliver the goods, if you are in a position in which you can ensure that people of your area, your constituency, are going to support you, it doesn't matter how old are you. Why should you then think in terms of having a retirement age for politicians? On the other side of this break, big interview coming up. Congress's chief spokesperson, head of the communication cell, Randeep Singh Surjewala, on all the questions which are being raised against the maths of the big promise which has been made by the Congress party. Is it 6,000 rupees per family or 12,000 rupees per family which is being offered by the Congress party? Straight answer coming up on the other side of the short break.